Can you tell me a little bit how the band evolved? Was it like a summer affair that turned into the love of your life?
Well, me and Fred, who plays the bass, and Eric, who plays the drums, we met in high school. So we were just kind of all loving jamming out and playing music. And I think that's where we had our first, like, we had the unanimous love affair with music, you know, and it just really kind of, we just gravitated towards each other. And later on we met Håkan, who plays the keys, and we lived together at one point in a kind of collective and started writing songs and just became like really good friends.
How's it like the musical scene in Sweden and in Gothenburg? Was it like hard to break through?
Yeah, I mean, we never really, it took us time. Like, I still don't think we've really broken through in Sweden. We got some radio play for Ritual Union, but I think we had a UK-based label from the start. So they focused more on their market than Sweden. And we haven't toured that much in Sweden either. But, you know, I think there are a lot of bands in Sweden, like so much. And a lot of bands that sing and play in Swedish and that are big only in Sweden. But I think, I don't know if it's easier than anywhere else. I'd say a lot of people struggle there.
And you have your own studio, right? That must be a very comfortable and productive way to work.
Yeah, it's great. It's really great. It's kind of our safe spot, you know. It's like our own little bubble, and we feel free there, and we lose track of time. Yeah, it's a special place in our hearts because we've been there for a while.
Do you go like there every day when you can?
Not every day, but sometimes I do go there and just hang out. Yeah.
Listen to music.
Yeah, we have a lot of vinyl and stuff, so, and it's like a little chill out area, so you can just hang out, listen to vinyl, make some tea or lunch or whatever.
And you've been touring extensively the past years. Did you feel like you had to stop and dedicate yourself completely to this album?
Really did, yeah. I think it was just kind of a bit of a race. For the first few albums, we just had to kind of sustain as a band. That was the only option. Just to go, go, go. So I think for this last album, we could really, you know, take a proper year off. And it was so, like, you appreciate it so much when you work hard for it. It was good to be in the studio and not feel any stress.
Like Nabuma Rubber Band has like this different sound than what we're used to. And it's like a more like slow jam feeling. What inspired you?
It's hard to say, but, you know, all the guys produce music and write, and I think in the past it's been very important for us to like really have more dancey up songs. And I think for the last record we were just like, whatever feels good and really has a vibe is what we're gonna go for, you know, it doesn't really matter. So it just ended up being more moody when we were picking, you know, the songs. We wrote a lot of songs that didn't end up on the record as well. So we were choosing our favorites, you know, just kind of piecing everything together. It ended up being, you know, that combination of songs. So.
And you all play all instruments, right? Do you really feel the changes when you're playing live? Because while you're on studio, you all play everything, right?
I mean, I wouldn't say that I play everything, but the guys definitely do, yeah. They all play keyboard, and obviously some are better. Eric's obviously the best drummer because he's a drummer.
And it's a very different kind of drums that he plays now in this album.
Yeah, I mean, it's different live because it just evolves that way different. But the guys sample all the sounds. We don't play with any backtracks or anything, so it's. So it still has that element of freedom in it when you play.
And the videos Clap Clap and Pretty Girls actually kind of feel like they were part of a movie. Are you like going to make like sequels of zombies taking over?
I think that was, the zombie moment is over. But it was fun to do it, definitely.
How did you bring Nabil on board?
I think we were just big fans, and he's done so much beautiful work, and it was something that we wanted to try.
I really have to ask you this. How do you feel about your own growth inside a Little Dragon? Because you started when you were 14, right? And how do you feel like an individual and an artist? How did you grow? And because you turned out to be this soft glam icon inside of the band and a fashion icon for us outside, how do you feel about all that?
I don't know. I mean, it's nice to hear it put like that, but I don't think about it. I guess in your own head, you just grow and change and from your experiences. And I mean, I think definitely the process of the band evolution was very kind of step by step. It wasn't like an overnight sort of explosion. So we all kind of humbled by that. It was a lot of hard work. And I think we all grew together, you know. We know each other now, so it's like we argue better.
That's amazing, because that's how family kind of works.
Yeah, it's like a marriage in a way.
And the last question is, last time you were here in Portugal was in the same festival but in another venue, I don't know if you remember, and the power went off on your show.
Oh, yeah.
Great. Are you feeling good about this one?
I feel good about this time.
With all these years, you kind of like know now how to deal completely with these situations?
No, it definitely stresses me out. No, the power goes out. I'm like, but yeah.
I'm feeling good about this one.
Feeling good about this one, yes, definitely.